Word number 57 for Tuesday, March 22nd, 2011. The word is fooled. Fooled. I was a high school student selling hi-fi gear, my very first kind of real job, and straight commission. I learned very early. I don't know how quickly, but I would say within the first few weeks, I learned that the number one fear that shoppers have, customers have, prospects have, is this fear. The fear of being fooled. The fear of being conned. The fear of being taken. We go to, my son likes magic and has practiced amateur magic. And it's kind of fun to watch him fool other people with magic tricks. But, you know, those are done in good fun, and they're entertaining, and they provide value. That's a different kind of being fooled. And we look at it with great mystery, and we wonder, how does he do that? It's especially fun to watch him with small kids. But by and large, we don't want to be fooled. We don't like to be fooled. We don't want to be made a fool. We don't want to look stupid. We don't want to be parted with our money. What's the adage about how quickly a fool and his money are parted? We don't want that to be us. And yet at the same time, do you live your life in with such supreme cynicism that you don't trust anybody? That you think everybody is out to dupe you? I mean, do you live with that kind of paranoia? Can't there be some balance between the feeling that you're going to be fooled and trusting people completely? Yeah, surely there can. Surely there can be. We talk about balance in all kinds of areas of our life, but when it comes to this notion of being fooled versus being trusting, there's balance there too. I'm mostly fond of practicing the art of not fooling people. I have worked hard my entire career, even as a teenager on a sales floor, just being as upfront and in some cases ridiculously honest. I'll tell you a story. This will illustrate a little bit about this whole notion of being fooled, because I came across in retail stores that sell, and I was selling hi-fi gear. So as a model changes and outgoing models become discontinued, stores by and large will sell their floor merchandise. They'll sell their floor demos. Now, there's a lot of foolery, tomfoolery, that goes on in retail when it comes to selling floor models. I'll just tell you flat out, there's a lot of lying that goes on. There's a lot of people that will try to tell you that, you know, it's only been out here, you know, for that. Well, you don't have any way to know how long it's been out there. And I got news for you, a lot of times they don't either. But what I would do, the very first time that this happened and we were selling off floor merchandise, I just leveled with people. And I said, yeah, we've had this thing. I put this thing out myself. We put this out about 6 months ago, and we turn them on every day. But, I mean, the thing's a workhorse. The thing's had no problem. You know, this burn-in period, this breaking-in period, that's over. You know, nothing has happened to this thing, and it's been running flawlessly this entire time. And the great news for you, the warranty doesn't start until today. You buy it today, the warranty starts today. But we've been operating this thing this whole time. So, you know, there's that. And you're saving a crazy amount of money over the model that's going to replace it. I didn't have any trouble.
I remember other people that I worked with thinking, that's just an odd approach. No, you don't do it. I didn't care. I did it the way I wanted to do it, and it proved successful.
And when I later got into management and leadership positions, I took a hard stance with sales teams in my entire life. Dismissal, it will come instantly if you lie. Because people don't want to be fooled, and you'll be the fool, because people will discover that they've been taken. They will discover that you've lied to them, and it's just bad business. It's bad business. Now, it didn't happen to fit with my sense of morality to lie, to cheat, to deceive, but I could make compelling arguments that to fool people, it's just bad business. It's bad business. Fooled is the word. It's not a feeling any of us like. It's not a feeling any of us enjoy, and there's an awful lot of it going around. The world's full of it. Got to be careful. Bernie Madoff, he ain't the only one out there doing it. There's plenty of others. Should you be skeptical? Yeah, you should. I mean, you really should. Should you be cynical? Sometimes. You should be skeptical. You should be willing to let people prove themselves, and people should be willing to prove themselves. If they don't, I think you should tune them out, and that includes me. You don't want to be fooled. I'm going to leave you with this, because it's probably the biggest, baddest form of foolery there is, and that is for us to fool ourselves. It's one thing if you fool me and I'm fooled by you, but it's something awfully, something just awfully darker and more sinister if I fool myself, if I'm fooled by my own delusions. It's hard. We got to do a lot of self-examination. We have to do a lot of introspection, and sometimes that's really the tough work, because we don't often like to do it. And then we got to make sure that when we're looking in this mirror, this virtual mirror at our life, that we're looking at what's real. I'm a big believer in soliciting and in having conversations and dialogue with other people, with people that know us, people that we know we can trust, people that we know will tell us the truth, and having real heart-to-heart conversations. I will give you a warning. Your friends, they won't be up for it right off the bat. You'll have to do some talking, but it's worth it. It's really worth it, because we're not used to being that open. We're used to, we care about their feelings. We don't want to hurt their feelings. But what do you do? What do you do if your best friend comes and says, listen, I want you to level with me? Those are hard conversations. Those are hard conversations. You know, the irony is, some of the toughest conversations are the most profitable. The word today was number 57, fooled. See you tomorrow.